Have you ever imagined being in complete control of a system that isn't even yours? Imagine discovering a hidden backdoor in an FTP server and using it to manipulate the entire machine. Sounds intriguing, right? Welcome to the world of ethical hacking. Here, every move is calculated, every tool is a game changer, and every vulnerability tells a story. Today we're diving into one of the most powerful and versatile tools used by ethical hackers worldwide, the Metasploit Framework. But before we begin, remember this. With great power comes great responsibility. This knowledge is for ethical purposes only, and misusing it can have severe consequences. All right, let's jump in. To set the stage, here's what we're going to do. Picture an outdated FTP server running on a vulnerable machine in our testing lab. Our mission is to exploit a backdoor vulnerability in this server and gain full control of the system. By the end of this video, you won't just understand how to use Metasploit. You'll also appreciate why it's an indispensable tool for penetration testers. Before we dive into the technical steps, let me explain what Metasploit really is. Developed by Rapid7, Metasploit is like a hacker's Swiss Army knife. It's a massive framework that houses thousands of pre-built exploits. This makes it an essential resource for cybersecurity professionals. These exploits help simulate real-world attacks. This allows us to identify and fix vulnerabilities before attackers exploit them. Now, let's get our hands dirty. Our first step is to identify our target. In our testing lab, we're using a virtual machine called Metasploitable. This machine is intentionally vulnerable, making it perfect for learning and testing. To find the vulnerabilities, we'll use a network scanning tool called Zenmap. Open Zenmap, enter the target IP address, and select the scan type intense scan. This type of scan provides detailed information about all the services running on the target machine. Once the scan is complete, look at the results. Among the various services, there's one that stands out. An FTP service running VSFTB version 2.3.4 on port 21. This version of VSFTB is known to have a serious backdoor vulnerability. At this point, we'll head over to the web and search for VSFTPD 2.3.4 exploit. A quick search confirms our suspicion. The vulnerability is well documented on Rapid7's own website, and it's available in Metasploit. Now it's time to fire up Metasploit. Launch the framework by typing MS console in your terminal. Once Metasploit loads, we're ready to search for the exploit we need. Metasploit has a treasure trove of pre-built exploits. We'll use the one specifically for VSFTPD version 2.3.4. The command to select this exploit is use exploit unix ftp vsftp underscore 234 underscore backdoor. Notice how the prompt changes when we select this exploit. It now indicates we're working within this specific module. Next, we need to configure some options for the exploit. To see what needs to be set, type show options. Two critical settings need our attention. Our host, which stands for the remote host or the target IP address, and our port, which represents the target port. The default R port is already set to 21. So we only need to set our host to the IP address of our target machine. We do this by typing set our host your target IP. Once everything is configured, double-check the settings by running show options again. Now comes the exciting part. Executing the exploit. Type exploit and hit enter. If everything goes as planned, you'll see a shell prompt appear. This indicates that we've successfully gained access to the target system. To confirm, type ID in the shell. The response shows we're now operating with root privileges. This means we have full control over the system. Now that we've gained access to the target system, let's take a moment to explore and understand what this level of control really means. As an ethical hacker, once you're inside the system, your first step is to verify the environment. Let's run the command uname a. This gives us details about the operating system, kernel version, and architecture. Why is this important? because it helps us understand the type of system we're dealing with, and whether additional vulnerabilities might exist. Next, let's use the ls command to list the files in the current directory. This gives us a sense of the target's file structure. It could reveal sensitive information, misconfigurations, or even passwords stored in plain text. But remember, every move you make must be intentional and well documented. Now, let's dig deeper by navigating through the directories using cd. For instance, if there's a directory named var www, this might host a website. Exploring it could reveal configuration files or potential vulnerabilities in the web application. We must demonstrate the full scope of the risk. To do this, you can try creating or modifying files to showcase the potential damage an attacker could inflict. Once we've gathered enough evidence, it's time to wrap up responsibly. Exit the shell by typing exit. Each command executes flawlessly, proving that we've taken control of the target machine. But let's pause here for a moment. Why are we doing this? The goal isn't just to hack for the sake of hacking. As ethical hackers, our mission is to understand vulnerabilities so we can help organizations secure their systems. In this case, the vulnerability we exploited was patched years ago. However, many systems still run outdated software, making them vulnerable to attacks. By demonstrating the impact of these vulnerabilities, we can advocate for better security practices. This includes keeping software updated, auditing systems regularly, and implementing firewalls and strong authentication mechanisms. In a real-world penetration test, we'd also document every step we took, from identifying the vulnerability to exploiting it and gaining access. This documentation is crucial for providing actionable recommendations to the organization. And that wraps up our journey into Metasploit and our first successful exploit. But this is just the beginning. In upcoming videos, we'll dive deeper into Metasploit's advanced features. Exploring post-exploitation techniques and learning how to secure systems against similar attacks. If you found this tutorial helpful, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications so you never miss an update. Got questions about Metasploit or penetration testing? Drop them in the comments, and I'll be happy to help. Always remember, knowledge is power, but it must be used responsibly. Hack ethically, stay curious, and keep learning. See you in the next video.